Hello, everybody, and welcome to the middle of the series. Now, wait a minute. If this is the middle of the series, why is it when I'm looking on the right-hand side of my screen, the playlist seems to indicate this is the last video in the playlist? Well, that's because there are chapters that just aren't done yet. You have now reached the end of the stuff that is finished, but don't worry, there is more stuff in the works. And in this video, we're going to show you some of the chapters that will be coming out real soon. So without further ado, let's go look at them, shall we? First chapter is actually first pair of chapters that are going to be coming out are both about filter revisers. In the very first chapter, we're going to be talking about the theory of filter revisers, which is going to show us how to use the calculate table and measures function. And there's an extra S there. That shouldn't be there. Calculate table and measures to change the filters before running sub-expressions. Now, this is going to do a couple things for us. It's going to most directly allow us to perform the static override pattern, the per item pattern. However, even more importantly than that, it's going to set us up to do the dynamic overrides in the near future. And those dynamic overrides, those will be the first really, really powerful thing that you do in DAX. And very importantly, when you do them, you will actually understand how they work, which is unlike a lot of the people that use them, right? It's hard, and you're going to know it. Congratulations, okay? So when we're done with the chapter on filter revisor theory, we're going to move into a chapter on filter revisor application. Short little chapter where we actually go open up Power BI, take all the skills that we learned in the theory chapter, and just apply them and make sure they work, right? Should be pretty fun, but should also be nice and confidence-inspiring because you'll actually get to go do stuff in Power BI. Now, that's what's coming immediately, those two chapters. We don't have a firm release date, but we kind of expect mid to late August is when we want to have those out. However, that's not the end either. There's more stuff coming after that. In addition to those two chapters in the works, we also have a chapter on dimensional modeling. It's not going to be a really long class on dimensional modeling. It's just a chapter. But what it'll do is it'll introduce the basic ideas of dimensional modeling. What is a fact table? What is a dimension table? And give us just enough information so that we can use it inside of DAX. Now, when we're done with that, we're going to take those ideas and dive back into filter revisers and talk about filter revisers when you have a dimensional model. In all the chapters previous to that, the data models only had one table in them. But in this chapter, the data models are going to start to have multiple tables, fact tables and dimension tables. And we're going to see what implications that has for our filter revisers, which will also give us a hint as to what kind of power that starts to unlock inside of DAX. When we're done with that, well, that'll be the end of the elements. We will have talked about all the major elements. And because of that, we're going to have a chapter where we review them. We're going to take all the information that we've learned and just review it, make sure we fully understand it. And when we're done with that, we're going to do a fun thing where we actually go and very much like in an earlier chapter, we rebuild, or I should say we build a summary table from scratch. Except this time, rather than just nodding your head and saying, wow, that's cool, I wish I knew how to do that, you're going to nod your head and say, hey, I actually know how to do this. Should be a lot of fun, okay? So that's some of the stuff that's coming up in the works. Gosh, we are incredibly excited to be working on and to release it. We hope you're excited to see it. And until then, well, may the DAX be with you.